This elemental fortune fairy strategy spans magical dimensions, converting draw power into on-field presence. The fortune fairy theme is a group of spellcaster monsters of all attributes who summon themselves from the hand when drawn. Then, they each have effects that trigger when summoned from the hand. Combined with the elemental grace Doriado and the versatility of link summoning, this deck was designed to win through miracles and draw power. Be sure to check out their standalone profile to see a better showcase of this build's potential with the Fortune Fairies. Mais oui, Fleur de PSY-Frame, the noblest of combinations. This build accentuates synchro summoning, accelerating the game state through a combination of noble and floral knights. This strategy's game plan is simple. First fusion summon, then synchro summon into your various boss monsters. One of which, Baroness de Fleur, brings negation and destruction as soon as it hits the field. But the PSY-Frame engine only adds additional disruption to your game plan, giving you even more chances to interact with the opponent. And don't forget the small Necro engine that provides even more tuners and more power through destruction. Accelerate your deck with the tailwinds of the Fleur theme. If only one could learn to be brave once more. Adventurous Brave Token features a new theme from the next deck build pack, a series of support cards that center on a single Brave Token on its journey through its world. In CDSS7, this build was upgraded with Fire Warriors, unlocking the true potential of Izzold, Twin Tails of the Noble Knights, to equip multiple equip spells at once to your Brave Token by sending them from the deck to the graveyard. Additionally, while you're doing that, you even get to summon one of your Brave support monsters straight from the deck. So combine adventure and versatility while you're being free to explore the home of the Brave.